Hello and welcome to IELTS Speaking, your all-time IELTS Speaking partner. And today we are back with an important update regarding Canadian International Study Permit for international students and some new, I can say, perceptions, new changes of rules to talk about band requirement and to talk about fees for colleges and universities. As you've seen in the thumbnail, that there is a chance of decrease in fee, there is a chance of change in the requirement, there's a chance of change in the rule. So what's the complete update? We will discuss in this video. So before proceeding, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon. We teach IELTS online and we also share the latest updates regarding IELTS, visa and immigration. So to enjoy your complete IELTS course and to get update regarding IELTS, visa and immigration on the very first number, hit the subscribe button now. It's completely free and press the bell icon to get notifications for that. And let's get started. Well, guys, to talk about the first update, that is regarding rule changes in Canada. It is expected that nowadays what is going on, everybody is sending us messages that they have 5.5 in one or they have 5.5 in two in IELTS. So they're saying that Canadian embassy will accept 5.5 band scores and will they give a visa with 5.5 or not. And nowadays everybody is saying that Canada will give visa with 5.5 bands because they want to increase the number of visas, because very less visas are issued, because in Jan and Feb only in these 2 months visas are issued. And after that, due to this lockdowns, all embassies and other application centers were closed. So no visa is issued till now after February. So they are saying that might be they will allow 5.5 band to give visa. Well, I want to tell you that they will not say anything that now they are going to accept 5.5 band score to give visa. If they want, then they will directly start giving application, because every year
Canada is, I can say, increasing the number of international study permits and other foreigners. So to talk about study permit, if Canada's, I can say, will not meet its, I can say, their conditions, the requirement that in this year they have to complete this much, they have to reach this target for international study permit. So if they are not able to reach their target, then definitely they can give visa to 5.5 band score. But they will not, I guess, give any official notice that no, we are going to accept 5.5 band score. If anybody applied with 5.5 band score, then they will just give them visa that okay, because if they want to increase the more and more international study permits. But if they will reach the target of, I can say, of a valid number, that in this year they want to give this much international study permits, so then they will, I don't know, that will they issue visa to 5.5 or not. Currently the requirement is that SDS is working with 6.5 or 6 with not less than 6 in any module. So they are not going to issue any update that now we are going to give visa to 5.5 band. It all depends if they will not able to reach to a particular number that in this year they have to reach this target. So then they can, there is a chance that they can give visa. I don't guarantee here, then it's on a chance. It's my perspective, it's perspective from our sources, that they can give visa to those who have 5.5 in 1, might be in 2. So till now, but I recommend everyone to apply in SDS category, because there are more visa chances. And nowadays, as due to this lockdowns, Canada has issued very less international study permit, and international students are a source of good economy to them. So they are will definitely going to issue more and more visas. We already discussed in our previous videos, you can check out that as well. So let's see what happened. And if you want to apply, that if you're saying no, I will apply in with 5.5 and so then you can consult with whom you want to apply, then they can guide you better. But the chances in SDS is more as compared to non-SDS. This is a common thing everybody know. So to talk about the next thing about fee changes, and so many candidates are saying that Canada is going to maybe reduce the fee. So yes, there is chances. Somebody is saying that Canada is going to increase the fee, but here is an opposite, I can say, opinion, that they may decrease the fee, because nowadays because of these lockdowns and so, colleges, institutions are also facing a lot of, I can say, decrease in economy. So they are offering decrease in fee. To talk about university in Vancouver, one university of Vancouver, I think York Village. So earlier the fees for any bachelor program was 20,000 Canadian for 1 year, but now they have, I can say, reduced the fee by around 3,000 Canadian, and it's around 17,000 something. So one more college in Vancouver is offering a decrease in fee, and not decrease in fee, what they're offering, they're giving an offer because they had a less number of, I can say, the seats were still available in the month of May. So they again opened May intake and started taking applications, and what they offered, they told that they will give 1,000 Canadian scholarship to students, as well as they will offer one free laptop to students. So these kind of offers institutions are, I can say, giving to students just because markets and shops and big brands do that. They just tempt others to towards them. So by giving this offer, they are tempting international students to join their institution, to join their college, university. So because everybody is now having very less number of students because of this lockdown, nobody's applying. It's a common thing. So everybody's trying to, fetch up a lot of students because they want to increase their economy, because nowadays they have an economy loss as well. So more and more offers are evolving, and might be in future more and more of these kind of programs, these kind of offers, scholarships will be evolved. So for those who have already paid fee, there is no any confirmation, because officially there is no any confirmation that they are going to decrease fee. It is just for Yorkville and this Conestoga College offer. So it all depends. It might happen. Might be they will shift in second year or whatsoever. There is no any confirmation. It is just a guess that will there be for an old student, or will it be in future as well or not. Currently, only these two are the updates that this university and this college offered a free laptop and 1,000 Canadian scholarship, and they just reduced the fee by 3,000 Canadian from 20,000 to around 17,000 Canadian. So let's see what happened in future with the complete update. So stay tuned with us, enjoy your complete IELTS course, and get the latest updates regarding IELTS, visa and immigration with us. We try our best to share the updates. If you need any kind of assistance, if you need, just comment down and we will try our best to help you guys out. Till then, give a thumbs up, take care, stay safe, bye-bye.